If you want to know how to calculate a certain number of Fibonacci sequences using Python programming language, or you just want to refresh your knowledge of recursion, you have come to the right place. Today we will write a recursive algorithm that can calculate any number of Fibonacci sequences. For this, we will be using Python programming language and test-driven development. But first, what is Fibonacci sequence? You can see a Fibonacci sequence on the screen. Every element of Fibonacci sequence is a sum of two previous elements, and the elements with index 0 and 1 equal 1. My name is Dyadya Sasha. I'm software engineer and test-driven development practitioner coming from testing and test automation background. On this channel, I teach how to write cleaner and more testable code by demystifying test-driven development, data structures and algorithms, DevOps and test automation. So don't forget to like this video and subscribe. In order to start, we will come up with the simplest case first, also known as the base case. Is there an index for which we know the value of the function in advance? Yes, there is. For example, index number 0, which is also the smallest possible valid index in our case. The result will be 1, which we will just hard code for now. As the next step, we will try to add more tests. Our second test will pass out of the box without any code changes. Our third test will require some code changes. We will add simple if branch with hard-coded return value for now. At the third step, we will add two more tests. Our fourth test brings some interesting observations. For indexes 2 and 3, the result equals index itself. For index number 4, the result equals index plus 1. Finally, by adding tests for index 5, we need to make a choice. Should we add a new if branch? In this case, instead of adding new if, we will finally implement recursive function call. The value of function for any index above 3 equals sum of values of function for two previous indexes. If you want to have a look at more detailed analysis of the function, feel free to check out a link to my blog in the description.
As you can see, a recursive algorithm of calculating a Fibonacci sequence is simple, short, and elegant. On the other hand, it is very slow and inefficient. If you want to know why it is so and how to fix that, please check out this video.